हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस नेक्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर दैट इज़ राइटिंग एन इफेक्टिव रेज्यूमे। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वीडियो लेक्चर वी ऑब्जर्व और स्टडीड हाउ टू राइट लेटर्स, जॉब एप्लीकेशन लेटर और फॉर्मेट्स ऑफ लेटर्स, टाइप्स ऑफ लेटर्स। ओके, सो राइट नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हाउ टू राइट एन इफेक्टिव रेज्यूमे। सो व्हाट इज़ दैट रेज्यूमे? रेज्यूमे इज़ प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द पर्सन हु वॉन्ट टू अप्लाई फॉर द जॉब, ओके, इन प्रोफेशनल वर्ल्ड और इन बिजनेस वर्ल्ड। This is about the definition about the resume. And CV, that is curriculum vitae, is composed by a person who specially wants to get a job in teaching field. Okay, for those people can only prepare a CV. Okay, and biodata is another concept in which we mention our biological details. Okay, our personal details, all things. That is called your biodata. So these are the three different concepts regarding biodata, CV and resume. But right now we are going to study how to write an effective resume for the purpose of getting the job. Okay, in previously we studied types of letters, okay, and layouts of letters. Right now let's proceed how to write an effective resume. So see here, what information should be in resume? This is the question is asked here again. Next, characters of successful resume we are going to study. Then types of a resume, those are functional and chronological and scannable resume. Okay, see what information should be in a resume. These some students might have known these things which are required for preparing a resume. Those are identify yourself, education, continuing education, work or professional experience, voluntary experience, activities, computer skills, professional association, and optional sections are objective, special skills and abilities, and reference statements. Means these things you may mention or you may not mention in the resume. Okay, again, characteristics of a successful resume are given here. So see what are the characteristics. Successful resume focuses on skills. It uses action words to define the responsibilities of your job related experience. Action words means, for example, organized, conducted, supervised, volunteered. These are such kind of action words are used in successful resume. Then it is easy to read and understand. Then visually powerful and free of gimmicks. And it covers one page or at most two pages long. Again, see, language is grammatically correct. Spelling has been checked and it has formal style. Again, there are some fox packs or typos or grammar mistakes. What are those typos and grammar mistakes? Means while typing we may commit some mistake. Those are called typos. Okay, see here, examples are given. Great attention to detail. It is grammatically incorrect. Then proven ability to track down correct errors. Now see, errors, errors should be there. Okay, so again here grammatical mistakes. In short, these are called typos and grammars. Then aim a perfectionist and rarely if you were perfect details. It has some mistakes. Again, accomplishments, completed 11 years of high schools. Again, it is we couldn't get the meaning properly. And don't use I or me. So these are the typos and grammar. We should avoid these things while preparing a good resume or effective resume. Then let's again come back to the successful resume. How to prepare that? It must always be 100% truthful. It contains no inappropriate personal information, and it produced on a computer. It has data which is presented in chronological order, unless in functional type of resume. We may not mention the data in chronological order. This is the difference between functional resume and chronological resume. We are going to study afterwards these things in detail. Then functional, what is called here? Functional resume. So it doesn't go in chronological order, as it is said before. Chronological order means the things you have completed recently we must mention first, okay, and afterwards the things you have completed in past you can mention there. Then it is based upon competencies and or skills. That's why it may be called again skill-based resume. Again, it is used for career changers or those who unconventional work histories or executives. Again, it might say sales experience then listed. Then typically brief with a simple list of positions held. and de-emphasizes the importance of specific jobs. Okay, so functional resume is prepared by a person who has unconventional work histories. Again, who want to change his job again and again. Those person can use functional type of resume. Again, it may have drawbacks to this system. Okay, so that's why it is not so much popular type of functional type of resume. Okay, then see here. Another type of resume is scannable resume. Means the reader or employer instantly scan your resume. In that way, you should prepare your resume. That's why it is called scannable resume. So what precautions should be taken? Watch bullet points. Okay, don't always scan. You may have bullets in your resume, or you may not have bullets in your resume. Then you should not use dash. Okay, most of the time when you go to the next line, we mention a dash. Okay, you should avoid that. Then use labels or keywords. Use labels and keywords. For example, extracurricular activity is a label. Then special achievements, it is a title or label. Okay, honor degrees, it is a title or label. So you should use such labels or keywords in your resume, in your scannable resume. Then less is more. Mostly you should use less information in your resume. Again, keep the design simple and minimize use of abbreviations. So this is called here scannable resume. Okay, so see here, let's see basic checklist while preparing the resume. There should not be spelling or grammar errors, one thing. Second, it should be neat, clean and professional looking. Then length should be 1 to 2 pages. Margins at sides and bottom should be there. Then layout makes readily easy. Use of white space is effective. Okay, whenever you use layout, there should be white space because it looks effective. Again, important titles should be emphasized. Experiment with fonts and styles, bold, italic, underlines, no more than 2 or 3 different sizes. Okay, you should give special effect to your font size. Then information is logically recorded. Means whatever information you are going to mention on your resume, it should be logically recorded there. Then use action verbs for accomplishments or results. For example, achieved a distinction degree. Achieved, this is the action verb. Then results, got first rank. Got is a action verb. Such kind of verbs you may use in your resume. Then bullet points when possible for accomplishments. Especially when you reflect your accomplishments in your resume, that time you may use bullets. Then quantify your results whenever you can. You may focus on your results whenever you want to do that. Then format should be chronological. Chronological in the sense that whatever information you are mentioning, it should be started from current to the past things. Okay, and it will create a good effect on the minds of the recruiter. Okay, then the things that we are going to study in complementary way, that is cover letter or job letter. Previously we studied how to write letters, types of letters, professional or business letters. But here a cover letter should be attached with your resume. Again, we are going to repeat the contents in cover letter. So see how to write a cover letter, rules and contents. Then give enough information to interest the reader. Don't overwhelm. Means whatever required information is there, you have those things you must mention in your cover letter, covering letter or job application letter. Then research the company, address the letter to a specific person. Before writing an application letter, job application letter, you should research the company, and accordingly you should compose your cover letter. Then answer an ad, means advertisement. If you have 50% of the skills or background that the ad requires, okay, means suppose you have that requirement, at least 50% requirement you can fulfill, then you may apply for that post. Then mention the person who referred you if appropriate. Okay, again mention the reference of those persons who have suggested that link, suggested that location, suggested that interview post. Okay, then how to write a cover letter. Contents here: your address, city, state, zip and telephone number you must mention, then date, then name, title, company, address, city, state, zip of person you are writing to, and greeting followed by a colon. Okay, these things you must mention in your covering letter. Then there are mostly 3 or 4 paragraphs are mentioned in your job application letter. Okay, so what are mentioned, what the things are mentioned in respective paragraphs? See, in first paragraph you may mention what you want, how you know about the organization, mention an enclosure of your resume. In second paragraph, mention concise overview of work history and skills that will help you perform the job. These things you may mention specifically in the paragraph number 2. And in third paragraph, mention the reflect your confidence in your ability. Then give information on how you can be contacted in the third paragraph. Again, paragraph 4, express appreciation. Means you may express your word of thanks in the last paragraph, in the fourth paragraph, for calling you for the interview. Okay, that is called here expressing appreciation. Then closing, signature and type name. You may end your letter, job application letter, cover letter with your name and signature. Okay, so successful interview skills we have already studied, so it is not required here to study again. Regarding this, I will provide lecture notes, again another study materials with this. So let us stop here. I hope you understood this one. Thank you so much.